Hello, I'm Jonghyun Park. Taking impressions, doing in the fixture level or above level, determining which and determining steps, very important in creating light prosthesis. Above level impression taking is very familiar to dentists, dental hygienists, and dental technicians, like taking impression of natural teeth. In this lecture, I'm going to talk about the abutment level impression taking and fixture level impression taking, its pros and cons, and how to do those impression taking. So first, about the abutment level direct impression. Fixed level impression taking in there, abutment impression taking and fabrication of the abutment and crown can be done at once. I always have challenge with bite registration in this white space, having the right occlusion and contact sometimes for me could be very challenging. However, after connecting the abutment and if we can take impression of the abutment like natural teeth, it's very familiar to many, and as the amount to be controlled would be very small, you can obtain very good results. Of course, I'm going to talk about fixture level impression at next lecture, but if I may give you some information here, hex and lab errors, if they can be removed, then there will be no problem. But given that the connection needs to be moved 5 times, there could be errors, thus increasing the chance for inaccuracy. But more recently, as the digital scanning has been adopted, transfer of connection is now only required twice. In the fixture level, even if you create the prosthesis at one go, the possibility of error has now been reduced. Let's look at a case. On the upper second premolar, there was fracture, so we planned for immediate placement. So this is the immediate placement of fixture. After that, we took CT photo. After 3 months, we digitally scanned, and abutment and crowns were designed simultaneously. As ostium was creating one fin abutment, zirconia crown was fabricated at the lab simultaneously. As it was done together, the advantage is that you can save time. Through digital scanning, the final prosthesis looked like this. The contact and occlusal seems to be all good. As soon as abutment is connected, if the crown can be cemented, then cement being spilled to subgingivally becomes likely. It's observation with incision, so it's not a direct evidence, but the attachment between soft tissue and the abutment seems to require some time. After connecting abutment, we take a direct impression, and while the final prosthesis is made without temporary, the abutment stayed in the mouth. As all was supra-gingival margin, it was easy to create prosthesis in the lab. Same stock abutment was used to check inner fit, and it's delivered to the clinic. And if it doesn't go in well, you have to just check the connecting strength with the adjacent surface. Once the abutment is connected, during 1 week, we hope that there will be some soft tissue attachment. And as it was supragingival margin, cement spillover seemed less likely. However, as the stock abutment was used and it proceeded created supragingivally, as you can see in this case, there could be some defect in the buccolingual side. All margins to be located supragingivally, then as there is irregularity in buccolingually and mesial distally, then you have to use abutment with the high gingival height. to improve form, gingival height being lower would give favorable results. But as in case of the supragingival margin, impression taking is easy. But subgingival margin taking direct impression can become very difficult. For me, on the upper anterior side, subgingival margin fixture is inevitable. And because of screw hole direction, cement type prosthesis is the only choice. So you have to think about minimizing cement spillover. After scanning the abutment, the die that's created through 3D printer is what I asked from the lab. From 3D printing die, cement is pushed and the margin area, the cement is removed. Then, through abutment screw hole to allow the excess cement to flow in there, we go with underfill. I observed in the mortar first to allow minimum excess flow, cement volume or amount, if it can be customized, then even subgingival margin fixture, the soft tissue and attachment is not sufficient. Excess cement can be minimized. So if it's ER type, gingival margin, or if there's less of soft tissue attachment, through this method, I control the cement amount. So another advantage of the amount level impression is that you have, you know, it takes about 1 week for prosthesis to be completed, and during that 1 week, the abutment is inside the mouth, and you can have another chance for screw tightening, in other words, 1 week later. So in the first day of abutment connection, if there's not full soft tissue attachment, if you can tighten screw after 1 week later, you can have more favorable result. Using stock abutment for insured implant delivery for many dentists, this is first choice. So if you can use stock abutment without modification for cancer restoration, I use this method. After stock abutment is connected, there's subgingival margin, but I just take direct impression up to the area I can see. You see there is not fully registration in the margin area, then the stock abutment of the same size is repositioned and the impression material is added on the margin area. The abutment is then removed and stone model is created. And you can see in the model the subgingival line being visible. Now in the lab, they can create their prosthesis very easily. So while the prosthesis is being made, abutment stays in the mouth, and up to the subgingival margin, metal crown was fully restored. Zirconia restoration is easier. The subgingival margin area exists, but up to the area you can see, just take direct impression. And same size stock abutment using model scanner in the lab, the image is stored, and the scanned image in the Egyptian image where it's not very clear, you overlap. If you use terminology merging, dentists and the technicians, I think both are familiar with such a terminology. And once that happens, then the pores on the model can also be eliminated. And in the subgingival margin image can also be acquired. So the subgingival margin image I have been fully acquired, and the lab makes the prosthesis. Zirconia prosthesis has been complete, and you can obtain adequate margin. So if you can use without stock abutment modification, just take impression up to the area you can see. And the next step is by merging the stock abutment of the same side, you can get the image and make the final prosthesis. Let's talk about a very easy approach. The disadvantage is that you have to take one more impression, and compared to stock abutment, custom abutment is more costly. First, in the fixture level, you take impression. The first impression is used for 1 feet abutment and also temporary crown making. And by using temporary between bone and soft tissue made more stable, and the abutment is self-submerged using occlusal force, then while the abutment is in the fixture, you take impression directly. Through that process, fixed level impression taking abutment connection related errors will be compensated. To make impression taking easily, supra margin would be the one you would opt for. If subgingival margin prosthesis is preferred, then before delivering abutment to the mouth, the abutment is scanned by model before delivering to me. And then I take impression in the area that I can see. And as we learned from the merging method, again, the merging method is also here used. And using the abutment level scan or merge is used for making final prosthesis. Let's look at the actual case. In the fixture level impression, 1 feet abutment is created and delivered orally, and temporary is used for about 1 to 4 weeks. After that, directly impression is taken, and from gypsum zirconia prosthesis is made. Final prosthesis is created. And the disadvantage of this method is that even if its supra margin is used for creation, soft tissue can grow and it could result in some issues. So these days, when the abutment is given to me from lab, I ask them to model scanning of abutment before giving to me, so I could compensate. But if that step is not done, then like this case, the margin can fall a bit short. And here, there could be some shigo shape or a dent. This is because abutment and if the prosthesis are created separately, as the space allocation would not be perfect, so the shape might not be complete, and this type of dent is often seen. And also abutment and crown, if they are also not created at the same time, another disadvantage is that shape-wise, it might not be perfect. It has a different emergence profile than natural teeth. But as when if subgingival area still remains, therefore making margin shorter, and if the shape is not so perfect, the most important thing is the fixture abutment connection. By using temporarily, you can make it more stable. Hence, it's an easier way. There's less problems. And by taking direct impressions, it's a familiar way to the lab, and also the clinic staff and the dentist also find this very familiar way, so there's less room for mistakes. Lastly, let me talk about abutment level direct scan. The stuck abutment delivered and then scanned. The subgingival margin was not scanned, only scanned up to the area I could see. Same size stuck abutment was called as image from the model scan and merged. As the same method I explained, it was merged, and subgingival margin image was easily obtained. Anterior side with this occlusal, if there was a gypsy model, it would have been difficult to mount, but with the scanning, you can obtain the model easily. So final prosthesis and only occlusal adjustment was made with minimum effort. So you can also do this with the custom abutment. But with the custom abutment, as there is no same size abutment, with the model scanner, they have to scan at the lab first before giving it to me. Then, even custom abutment, you can scan only up to area you can see, give it to the lab, then margin, the subgingival margin can be easily, those images can be easily obtained. I only scanned up to the area that I could see, but through margin, I could easily obtain the margin information. Hex connection is sometimes tricky, so you miss sometimes mistakes that you made, or the misconnection you have made, narrow area or number 7 area. So in that those cases, there could be a lot of errors. So in that case, the approximate fixture connections problem solved, and then impression taking, it will be okay. So I prefer abutment level impression taking. You first connect the abutment, and in the impression taking model, you create the upper prosthesis separately. Then form-wise, it might be not perfect, as space allocation will not be perfect. But the fixed abutment connection is well, that even the margin is not perfect, if the prosthesis shape is not perfect, there's less room for critical errors to happen. Abutment level impression is something where anybody can obtain 80 points or higher results. So it's very attractive. If you have any questions, let us know using the Deno bulletin board. We'll be more than happy to answer your question. Then I'll see you at the next lecture. Thank you very much for your attention. 함께 해주신 여러분, 고맙습니다.